Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Tori, and what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to bring you guys a piece of information that I feel is extremely important for everybody who's looking to join Motor Club of America, okay? Now this information you guys aren't going to find on YouTube, most likely. I haven't seen no videos or nobody putting this stuff up, and I feel like this stuff is very important. The history of our company, you guys need to know about this because you guys are going to have to explain this to everybody like I do when people ask me questions. So you guys want to know, you'd be on top of your game. When people call me on the phone, I give them a brief history of the company. But what I'm going to do here is I'm going to break it down even more in depth for you guys, you know. So, like I said, you guys, you know, a lot of people aren't focusing on this stuff, and this is what a lot of people want to hear. You know, because I remember when I first started, I wanted to hear about this kind of stuff. You know, I didn't want to hear about the money and stuff all the time that people are making, even though the money looks good and all that. But, you know, I want to hear about the history. I want to hear the background of this company. So I'm about to give you guys all of that and some. All right, now, if you guys go to Google, you guys can, you know, you guys got a really deep, dig for this stuff. But you guys will find this stuff, and it's where I found everything. So, with that being said, guys, I took like a minute for this intro. But with that being said, here we go, okay? So, basically, you guys, everybody knows Motor Club of America was founded in 1926. Well, that's what people say. Motor Club of America was founded in 1926. And the truth behind that is, no, it wasn't founded in 1926. What happened was the Green brothers, William, David, and Samuel Green, what happened was they wanted to find some kind of auto coverage for automobiles, because around that time in 1926, automobiles were fairly new. So they wanted to find some kind of, you know, coverage to help people on the road and all that. So, you know, so they started doing this for a little bit, and, you know, and in 1933, they had came up with a name because, you know, by this time, the company, their services were starting to expand so much that they're like, yo, like, we need to, you know, come up with a name and start, you know, doing more things. So they came up with the name, you know, the Automobile Association of New Jersey. And so by 1933, this company, you know, the Automobile Association of New Jersey had expanded to over 13 states. They were starting to, you know, expand everywhere by this time, you know. So, you know, then they were getting, like, their buzz up or whatever the case may be. And then in 1958, Motor Club of America, they changed the name to Motor Club of America. So then you had Motor Club of America, the insurance company, MCAIC, Motor Club of America Insurance Company, and, you know, and Motor Club of America, they both partnered up together and everything. So, you know, basically, as the years go on, you know, Motor Club of America, you know, an insurance company and everything, they're doing well, they're making money, they're opening up hospitals, they're opening up, you know, all these different things and stuff like that. You know, they're putting money into all these different things, and they're doing great up until 1972. And, you know, like I said, this was, you know, based out of New Jersey originally. That's where the Green brothers were from. Paramus, New Jersey is what it was. And in 1972, what happened to Motor Club of America, which ended up being, you know, something that really, really hurt the company. You know, in a business, there's sometimes you know, downfalls that occur, and, you know, the business has to build itself back up and everything. But in 1972, what happened was New Jersey had passed something called the no-fault law. So what I want to invite you guys to do is to go look that up, what the no-fault law was. And basically, you know, what happened was, it started to be the downfall of Motor Club of America because, everybody had to be covered under Motor Club of America. And so they started to build themselves in a hole with all these different people trying to be covered and all this, you know, this crazy stuff going on. Ended up being a downfall. It ended up getting themselves into a bind because it is, you know, like a large financial state. They were in a large financial state just because of what happened in 1972 with the tax law or with the no-fault law. And so they were fighting this for many years and everything, you know, many, many years they were fighting, you know, to, you know, and then eventually in, like, the 1980s, they asked for, I have notes in front of me, guys, so I may have to revert back to my notes sometime, because when I say I'm going into depth, I mean I'm really going into depth. So the company filed a lawsuit against the commissioner in the state of New Jersey seeking compensation for the injury caused by the New Jersey regulations. So that's what happened. They filed a lawsuit because the law that was passed was hurting Motor Club of America and other insurance companies as well, but particularly Motor Club of America, after they put all that time and effort into things to build their company and everything. Now, all of a sudden, things started crashing because of this law that New Jersey had passed. And, you know, so they seek to file that lawsuit and everything else. So then, let's fast forward a couple more years, right? Now, a lot of things happened, because, like I said, Motor Club America, they had, like, a whole bunch of subsidiary company, or, you know, companies along with them, you know, because they had, you know, the company for home insurance. You know, they had a whole bunch of different things. But I'm just focusing mainly on one thing, guys. So then eventually in 1987, you know, TVC Marketing was bought out by Virgil Coffee. So if you guys don't know who Virgil Coffee is, he was a mastermind behind the whole Prepaid Legals Inc. corporations back then. You know, he was the mastermind behind the compensation plan and everything. So Mr. Virgil Coffee, he's just a mastermind. He's just brilliant. And so what he did was he partnered up with Motor Club of America, because TVC Marketing or whatever, they used to provide coverages for truckers. They used to be the truckers insurance. So they combined with them and everything with Motor Club of America. Now they launched a whole new thing to provide coverages for automobiles and everything. So now the automobiles, you know, can be covered and everything else, you know. So basically today, if you ask truckers, most truckers know what Motor Club of America is, because, you know, they're associated with the TVC marketing aspect of it and everything. So I brought you guys up to par with, you know, 1987. We got Mr. Roger Coffey, bought TVC Marketing. They combined it with Motor Club of America. Now we have auto insurance for cars and trucks and all this other stuff, right, guys? So then, you know, by 1991, so they were doing good. They were getting back up on their feet again, you know, because of what happened prior to that with the New Jersey laws and everything. So they're starting to get back on their feet. So now by 1991, they started to go back down again. And in 1992, what happened was in 1992, there was a hurricane. Let me look for the name. Hurricane Andrew. So Hurricane Andrew had hit in one of the major cities where Motor Club of America was at. It was like on a South Florida coast. So eventually, the Motor Club of America Insurance Company, they were wiped out. They were wiped out by all the losses and caused by the storm, and they were placed in reservership. So basically, you know, as a result, Motor Club of America, they wrote off more than $23 million in losses. So $23 million in losses, you know, that's a lot of money for a company to have to, you know, to come back off of. Like, that's a lot of money. So, you know, so basically, guys, like I said, I have notes here and everything, so, you know, it goes very, very, very much in depth. And so that's pretty much, you know, that part of it. So this is what happened. So, guys, eventually, Motor Club of America, I'm off my notes now. So eventually, Motor Club of America, right, they had to, another company had bought them out. It was called Preserver Group. So Preserver Group had bought Motor Club of America out, and, you know, they were, you know, and basically they did the same, they offered the same kind of, you know, insurance that Motor Club of America did. And eventually, the Preserver Group was bought out by a company in 2006. I don't know the exact date. April 10th, 2007. I'm sorry, 2007. It was called Tower Group. So the Tower Group bought out Preserver Group, who had bought out Motor Club of America. So now, like today, if you were looked, Tower Group is the actual insurance company. Because right now, Motor Club of America, the Motor Club of America that we know as of today, it's not the same as it was back then, because in 2011, you know, well, 2007 is when the Tower Group bought it out and everything, you know what I'm saying? So then in 2011, in October 2011, this is basically where we're at today. Motor Club of America relaunched itself, not as an insurance company, but as a benefits company. So now we offer benefit packages to everybody. So now, you know, people like you and I can go around and refer people into the company and sell these benefit packages. Which is brilliant because, you know, they can reach out to the masses this way. If they have different offices set up, you know, like some of our top competitors, they have different offices set up, you know, they can't reach out to masses and masses of people like we can. Like, we go on YouTube, like I'm about to put this video on YouTube. You guys are probably watching on YouTube right now. And I can blast this to, you know, 50,000, 100,000 people. And that's going to bring more business to them. So a lot of people always ask, like, why is this company ranked that? And this is exactly why. They can reach out to more and more people this way. So, like I said, guys, it's a benefits package that we offer now. It was launched, the whole package was launched in 2011 in October, which included the compensation plan that we have today. So with all that being said, this is where we're at today. Motor Club of America, the benefits packages we have to offer. This is why we, you know, when Virgil Coffey, like I told you guys earlier, you know, when he was the mastermind behind the prepaid legal and all that, you know, this is why we have in our company today in the benefits package. This is why we offer the legal defense, for an attorney to defend you up to like $2,000 and everything. This is why we offer all that, because all this was in place back then, because these brilliant guys, they put all this stuff into effect already, you know. So Motor Club America has a lot of history in it, and you guys need to take the time out to do your research, look it up. let everybody else know about this company, because honestly, people want to know the history about the company. People want to know the facts about the company. And like I said, take this with a grain of salt. You know, there's a lot of stuff that I missed. And, you know, I can't break down every single subsidiary that Motor Club of America had and all that. Can't go through all that. I mean, this video will be forever. So I just want to bring you guys that short clip. And if you guys have any questions whatsoever, you know, just email me. My email will be down below in the description. You know, visit my website. Check my other videos out, guys. I'm very, you know, try to stay up on top of this. I try to become as educated as I can about this. Not only do I try to sell, you know, packages to everybody, but I try to educate people as well because people need it. And honestly, guys, the education sells itself, just like the benefits sell itself. So at the end of the day, you don't even have to tell people, like, hey, you can make money off of this. Don't sell the compensation. Sell the benefits and the history of the company, and you will succeed. Once again, guys, if you have any questions, just email me. My name is Tori. I'd be more than happy to talk to you guys. All right, so just get educated. That's all I have to say. Just get educated, and you'll be fine. All right, once again, my name is Tori, and I'll talk to you guys later. Thank you.